Hi, hello, welcome back to this video where I'm always the happiest. Actually, no, scratch that. I'm not always the happiest when I sit to do beauty videos, because of late I'm also just as happy doing vlogs. Vlogmas 2021. I want to say kind of change the trajectory of my YouTube career, because I would always be a little bit more skeptical about our vlogs real content. I can do them as fillers, but not fillers, like filler videos. But are they like real content? Are people interested in them? And clearly you guys have been interested in them. But my heart loves doing sit down talking about beauty kind of videos very much as well. So let me kind of just get that out of the way. I love them equally. I don't think I can choose one over the other. Both are equal. You didn't ask, but I've gone on a random rant, and you can tell that I'm in a fairly chatty mood. And you and I are going to talk about a lot of makeup products today. Today we are going to do a full face of Huda Beauty. I am so excited because there's a lot of products over here that I actually have not tried, and I'm really excited about trying them because I love Huda Beauty as a brand. I think that they make amazing products. There have been one or two misses as well, so not to say it's been all hits. I am going to give you honest first impressions of everything. The products that I have over here next to me are a mix of purchased as well as received in PR, because as you know, Huda in India is available on Nykaa, and they keep sending stuff as well as and when there's a new launch. So you are going to get a very first impressions. You are going to get a very real raw first impressions, because we'll try some of these products as we go along, and then there are a couple of them that I already have used, so I'll be able to share more thorough reviews with on those. But I'm quickly gonna prep my face. As you can see, I'm doing at the moment, I am using the Summer Fridays Jet Lag Mask. You guys have seen me use this quite a bit because I really truly have been enjoying it. I've said this before, but I'll say it again just in case you're tuning into this video and into my channel after a while. It does have a little bit of a fragrance that I don't particularly love. It's not too mild. It's somewhere in the middle. I wouldn't even go so far as to call it strong per se. But at the beginning, it did bug me a little bit. But then I realized that the way this hydrates my face, and it's a nice thickish cream where sometimes, like, I don't even need a primer. Like today, I'm not going to go ahead with the primer, only because I don't need it. Also because I realized I don't have a Huda primer, and I don't think Huda does primers, but I should double check that. I'm really happy with this particular product. I'm also going to really, really quickly go ahead and use my Verified lip oil. If you guys are keeping up with my brand, we launched the Verified lip oil as well as the lip plumping gloss early in December. I hope you guys are enjoying Vlogmas, because it was, well, the launch was part of the Vlogmas series technically. And I hope that you guys have tried some of the Verified products, and if you have, let me know what they are, like what your favorite ones are. BD dubs, we are doing a giveaway. What was BD dubs? By the way, we are doing a giveaway in today's video, so make sure you stick around till the end. Make sure you stick around through the video, because I'm going to tell you what you're getting from me in this video. Oh yeah, we're giving away Huda Beauty products, just to clarify. Okay, I've changed my hair about 3 times, and I think that this weird half updo, half whatever it is, works best to keep my blow dry intact without ruining it, while also being able to help me get my makeup on without making a mess. We are going to now dive into the makeup, which is what we're here for. I'm starting out with foundation. Now, this is going to be a moment of truth, because as usual, I have not bothered going into the stores, and I have selected my shade online. The one I've selected for myself is Latte 300 Neutral. In the older version of the same foundation, I used to wear Brown Sugar. But what I have realized for myself over the years is that I used to choose shades for me, which used to be leaning yellow, whereas I am a neutral baby. So that's a correction in my makeup routine that I've made over the years. And we have a winner. It's a great match. It's a great, great, great match. I also always leave a little bit of benefit of doubt, because a lot of foundations do oxidize. this is blending very, very easily. I'm using the Verified Foundation brush. This is brush number 5 that we have over here. It gets a lot of compliments, if I'm being honest, because this angled shape really, really makes everybody's life easy with application, with blending, goes into all like the corners and crevices, even your under eyes, very, very smoothly and evenly. What do we have here? So it's also drying up relatively fast. So I need to work a little bit faster with this product. Like I can already see it settle. Maybe the word is not dry. Maybe the word is settle. It's also settling relatively fast. So allow me a second to please speed through this. Okay, on camera, why is it looking so much lighter on the face than my neck? That's weird. Because when I'm looking at myself here, it's exactly the same shade. So we're going to give this some room to move and hopefully oxidize. And then we're going to go from there and see what happens. Because believe it or not, after I finish this entire tutorial today, I have an event to go to. So I can't be leaving the house looking much whiter, lighter here. That's not okay at all. So we'll fix that with another foundation if we have to before leaving for the event. But I'll try and stay true to just this foundation for this video. If I need to make any adjustments, I will do it after filming, after giving you a thorough review. Because if I land up mixing another foundation into this, or even just the different shade that I have, brown sugar from the same range, into this, I fear that I will not get the same single even layer foundation finish that a lot of you will get in user experience. So I don't want to, you know, kind of mess with that at all. I'm gonna keep this as is and then we'll go from there. Okay, there's work going on here and there, so I apologize for any random sounds coming from my ambience. Yeah, it's definitely looking a lot lighter on camera. I'm looking at my screen right now and realizing that. I don't know why though, because in person it is looking pretty close to my shade. I'm gonna say pretty close, I'm not gonna say exact. Did I take too much product? I don't think I took too much product. Really not happy with how this foundation is looking on camera. On my skin, it's feeling really nice and light. Like I can't even tell that I have foundation on me. It's feeling really lightweight. The only thing off about it from the way it's looking on camera for sure is just the shade. In terms of in person and in terms of experience, this was really easy to blend. This was really easy to work with. I would recommend putting foundation on half your face and blending it out and then going on to half your face and blending it out. This is a little bit more similar to the way the Fenty foundation, the very first Fenty foundation that had come out. I remember doing a review of it in 2017, I think. I'm gonna go ahead and leave a link into that video somewhere over here and down below. Make sure you go check that out. Even at that point of time, I remember doing the new Huda foundation review as well. So I've always been into foundation reviews and wear tests and things like that. And I just kind of feel, like it's feeling so nice on the face. It's settled in already, like with that soft matte finish. I feel like I needed to probably mix up a little bit of brown sugar into this or any other slightly deeper shade into this. So we're gonna overlook that for the sake of this video for now. I am gonna fix it later before I go to my event. We'll warm it up with contour and color and that kind of stuff in a bit. Next up, it is time for concealer. Now here's hoping the concealer is a good match, because this is the first time I'm using this particular concealer. The exact name for it is the 4 filter luminous matte concealer. Now if you've tried the overachiever concealer from Huda, which also I have reviewed over here on this channel in the past, you will know that I absolutely love that concealer. I've purchased and repurchased it, and in a joking manner, but probably like I'm just trying to explain how good it is. I've said to multiple people and maybe to you guys as well in the past, it is so good. It will conceal the sins of your past life. Like it is that good. It is one of those kachak absolute full coverage concealers. The disclaimer I have about that concealer is that you cannot wear it without a full glam face. I have tried wearing that concealer with no foundation, and even though I have skin that's relatively clear, touch wood, alhamdulillah, on days when I just try to wear that, it looks weird because my under eyes look kachak, like smooth, finished. Kachak sounds so weird. And then the rest of my skin looks like skin. So with that concealer, because it's a very matte, full opacity, high coverage one, you can't wear it without foundation. Let's see how this one does. This is also from the Huda Beauty 4 filter family. Okay, off the bat, I absolutely love this applicator. It's not really a doe foot applicator. It's a little bit spongy. It's a little bit like the kind of applicator you would have for like a lip product. To be, I was about to put it on my lip because I said lip product. That you would put on like a lip product. Really easy to apply with. Now what I am going to do is quickly blend this before going to the other eye. I do realize I haven't told you what shade it is. Give me a second. I'm going to double check it. Bear in mind, I'm trying these products for the first time today with you. The area next to my table is full of packaging. Okay, that blended in really well. Wow, that blended in really, really, really well. That was very easy to work with. Almost just too easy to work with. I'm curious to see if this is something that can be, because it's good, it's got good coverage. It's not as high coverage as the Overachiever, and it's got a little bit of that luminosity in it, which is a good thing, because sometimes with matte products they absorb all luminosity to a point where that area of your face may not even look healthy, if that makes sense. Okay, that's beautiful. Can you see the difference in my left and right side? I have only foundation on this side, and I have foundation and the concealer on this side. That is really fantastic. I'm gonna just go ahead and add up a little bit more, because I feel like I've got like a mediumish coverage. Will it get built up to give me a full coverage? I don't know. Let's find out. I'm also always really curious to see if products layer up really well, like build up really well, because that is a very good tell as to how smooth and, you know, how smoothly finished the product formula can be. I'm also seeing a little bit, not much, but I'm also seeing a little bit of blurring on the under eyes, huh? Like, that's kind of nice. It's not enhancing my lines at all. And the shade is clearly a match. Is it a match on screen as well? Yeah, okay, it's a match on screen as well. That's really good coverage. I'm happy. I really, really am. Okay, I've made a little bit of a goof up, by the way, and this is a me goof up, obviously. I did not order the Huda Beauty loose powder because I thought I had it, and I did have it. What I didn't realize was that it was over, and that's my fault. So we're going to work with another loose powder today just to kind of set that in place. So even though I said this is a complete full face of Huda, you know, makeup thing, I'm really sorry. That's my mix up. When it comes to the powder, it'll have to be non-Huda. And I don't think Huda has a brow product because I didn't find anything. So the brow product and the loose powder are both going to be non-Huda. So just going to put that disclaimer here. Straight away going in with a little bit more product, so I don't necessarily have to layer it, just to kind of get a sense of how it performs in both cases. Is there a smell in this? Like a good smell? Yeah, there's a fragrance in this for sure. It smells like something sweet, not like a vanilla anything, but it smells like something that I would eat. What's my shade called? My shade is Caramel Corn 5.1. It doesn't smell like caramel corn, but it definitely does have a mild fragrance to it. It doesn't bother me because it's a very mild fragrance. I think I'm more upset when skincare has fragrance than anything else, but what is it? I can't put a finger on it, unfortunately. Just really quickly gonna use the Fenty Beauty loose powder. I'm using this in the shade Banana to set my under eyes in place. I have used the Huda one before and it is really good, so it definitely does have my recommendation. My shade in the Huda Beauty loose powders is Kunafa, and it really helps with setting and baking as well. If you're looking for a tinted one, tinted option that's available in India, I would 100% recommend that. It is a slightly thicker full coverage kind of loose powder, so it's not finely milled at all. But if you are looking for coverage, that one is going to be your best friend. I can promise you that. I know so many makeup artists who swear by that particular loose powder. Is the shade beginning to look better on camera? Yeah, it is. So it does oxidize. I'm clearly seeing a little bit of a discoloration here because I did take the foundation only till here. So I'm a little bit confused about whether this is an exact match and whether it's going to settle along the course. Let's come back to this check thing in maybe towards the end of this video. So we'll have a clearer idea of how much it does oxidize. We can do a little bit of a before and after and figure from there. I keep saying figure from there. Why is that my new thing? Let's quickly do my brows off cam. Really, really quick because I concentrate a lot while doing my brows. Using the Benefit Brow Pomade. I recently restocked this from Nykaa as well. And using my Verified number 07 brush to do my brows. Give me a second and I will come back to you because I cannot talk through doing my brows and my liner. It doesn't happen. I'm back. I don't know who I am because I'm having cold coffee today. I'm such a chai person. I had chai this morning, but it's going to be a long day for me. So I'm clearly like building up on that caffeine. My brows are done. I'm really happy with how they are. I don't think I'm ever unhappy with my brows when I use the brow pomade. It's just one of those things. I love me a good brow pomade. And I have realized that I am a brow pomade junkie. Shall we do eyes first or shall we do face first? I feel like let's do face first because it'll go a little bit quicker. I don't know what I want to do with my eyes when I open the palette. I'm hoping I'll feel a little bit inspired. For the contour, I'm using the Huda Beauty Contour. I'm wearing this in the shade Light. I don't know if you remember this, but I bought the first one when I was in Cannes for the Cannes Film Festival a couple of years ago. I was vlogging on that trip, but I don't think I used to vlog then as much as I vlog now or even the way I vlog now. I feel like for me at that point of time, vlogging was just about the highlights, whereas now I literally think aloud while vlogging. Like, it's almost become one of those things that I constantly have my camera as company. Yes, I'm trying something totally new with contour. My hand just kind of went there and I felt like doing it. I have been trying this off camera a little bit. Like, this is the third time I think I'm trying it. Why am I doing this in a day? I have an event to go to later. I do not know, but now it's done. I've committed and I will see this through. This is a product I can give you a full-fledged review on because it is a product I've been clearly using for years. Very, very, very easy to work with, very easy to blend, very pigmented. So don't take too much or you'll end up looking and feeling muddy. Take a little bit lesser. I've made a mess. I can see it on camera. It is looking like a mess. It is not looking like the model of duty type contour thing that I've successfully done only once before. So I'm going to focus on this for a quick second. I'm using the number 6 brush from Verified. In case you do care about tools, once again I apologize for the noise that must be coming from out of the window. There's construction work going on somewhere around and I can't do anything about it. Can I make it work or should I wipe it off? I love this product. I do. It's very easy to work with. It's very pigmented, so you don't need to take too much. I barely touched it and went all the way, but now I'm like, oh god, it looks like a line. I need to blend it further. Is it slimming my face? Have I done it successfully again? I don't know. We'll find out towards the end of this look. And if I haven't, it's okay. It's just makeup. You can wipe it and redo it. This product, as I've been trying to say, is really easy to work with. One of the things I did get wrong is that I thought I was going to land up buying a medium shade. But when I tried it out in person at the Sephora in Cannes, I bought the light. So if in case you're buying this online, whatever you think your shade is based on online, I would suggest that you go one shade lighter just because it is pretty easy, to be honest, too. Just because it might be a little bit confusing from the picture point of view. I think that the Huda brand in general does a really great job with helping people choose their shades online, like even on their own website. And again, you will find that on Nykaa as well because I have selected stuff from Nykaa. See, this side was easier because I took lesser product. So I think it's going to be easier for me to work with. Even though I took less product here, I think I'm just using this product after a little bit. Why did I just dip my brush back into it? Why did I just do that? Wiping it off on a tissue a little bit and just blending. Oh, in case you're wondering why I didn't take the loose powder everywhere on my face, I don't tend to do that. I tend to use a pigmented loose powder only and only on my under eyes and nowhere else. I will use my IRL everywhere else usually. Today I'm not doing that because this is a full face of only Huda Beauty. But just putting it out there in case you're wondering about my routine in general. See, this side is easier. It was easier to work with and easier to create. This side has blended up really beautifully. So basically, you kind of are making a weird diamond shape with your contour. Will I get used to this? I don't know. Should I get used to this? You tell me in the comments. Diamond contour, yes. Or diamond contour, no. I think I like it. Makes me look a little more chiseled. Let's just call it that. Okay, we're now going into the cheeks. So we have the cheek tint over here. This shade is called Coral Cutie. Coral Cutie. Oh my god, why was I going to say Coral Cute? Coral Cutie. Now, I have to tell you that I'm a little bit of a stick product skeptic. So if this one wins me over, it's going to be really surprising and clearly really impressive. The reason I'm a little bit skeptical about using sticks for blushes, not so much for contours, for blushes, is because I do have dry skin by default. The foundation we've used today is a soft matte foundation, and I just feel like in general powder products, I don't know if you could hear that. I just feel in general powder products work better for the Indian climate. Keep in mind, I do have dry skin and I'm saying that. So I really was very curious to see if I would like this or not. Naturally, I am. Okay, it's not a matte cream. It's definitely got some pearly radiant finish in there. Taking a blender. So I'm not seeing as much tint in residue. I'm seeing more reflect in residue. Can you see it as well? And see, this is why I'm a skeptic. Because I'm like, when I want color on my cheeks, I just want color on my cheeks. It is what it is. I mean, I don't mind the radiant fresh finish because that is looking really nice, I'm going to say. But where's the color? Where's the color? Because when you apply foundation on your face, you're basically cancelling out all your natural color, that natural freshness that your skin brings, which is why we add contour to add some dimension again, for, you know, more shadow work essentially, which you've covered with foundation, which is why when you add blush, you're adding that little pinch effect of the cheek, because naturally your skin does have some amount of color on the cheek, which you've again cancelled out with foundation. I'm just going to build up some more. Guys, if you're a cream product person, this might be for you. Please keep in mind, I am very picky about cream products. I just am. Okay, see, now when I've applied more, I can see the coral finish. See, this I can live with. But I still feel like, especially on camera now when I'm looking at the screen and not at the mirror, you can see the shine more than you can see the coral. And now I'm just downright confused because it's given me such a nice dewy finish, but I don't necessarily want to add highlighter by the end of it. I don't know what's happening. Let's just work with it and see how we feel. Sometimes products take some time to settle. I am going to do a summary roundup by the end of this. Yahan pe, I'm putting a little bit more because now I've realized I need a little bit more for the color to really shine through as well and not just the finish. I was saying, don't worry, by the end of this video, we will do some rounding up thoughts and favorites and hits and misses. Yeah, see, I can see some color. Again, on camera, the color is not picking up. So I'm a little bit confused. But in person, I can see the coral on both sides. I'm going to layer this up one more time just to match both the sides. I would actually reach for this product on a day where I'm not looking for a full glam finish. You know what I mean? Like if I have no foundation and I'm just doing a concealer mascara kind of day, this product would make absolute sense because then I don't need to go for a separate blush and separate highlighter because it just has that glow and that reflect in itself. Am I making sense? But if I'm looking at this on foundation on a day when I want full coverage, that's where I'm a little bit confused about it. Okay, so I'm just going to let this sit and we're going to move on to eyes. I don't like to do my highlighter right after doing my contour and blush. I like to do my highlighter as the second last step of my routine. Typically, I like my last three steps of my routine are IRL Paris filter all over, highlighter and then lipstick. So today it's going to be highlighter and lipstick just because I like for the highlighter to be fresh and glowy for as long as possible. The eyes. Now what do I tell you about this, because this is a product I have already been using. I attended the Huda Nykaa event I think a couple of months ago and this product was received in PR and I love it. Spoiler alert for whatever we're about to do next. I have done so many looks, casual events, red carpets, wedding, over the past 6-7 weeks whenever I open this, and I have been loving this palette. I am going to give you a little bit of a review even before I start using it. If I'm being honest, you will experience some amount of fallout in the powder products over here. Just going to put that out there. Do I mind it? No, I don't. But I'm also coming from a little bit of a technical standpoint here. So give me a second, 30 seconds, hear me out. The thing is, if they would have gone ahead and pressed this further, and I'm saying this not because they've said this to me, I know this because when I'm working on Verified, this exact problem was faced by me while formulating our blush. If we had prevented more of that fallout, applying the same logic here is what I mean, it wouldn't blend as easily. You know what I mean? So when they want to press a product down more, you have to add certain binding agents more. And while it's great to prevent the fallout here, it will not blend and dissolve into one another with as much ease. That same logic applies to all powder pigments. And I just feel like they've done a fab job. There is some fallout. Like, for example, if you have used the Verified blushes, I will tell you myself, there is a certain amount of excess powder that your brush will pick up on. But if I would have reduced that fallout, much like here, it would not blend and look as blurred and, you know, just like almost sprayed over with a little blurring finish. And I apply the same reference to this, which is why, and to product in general, now that I know the technical side of it a little bit more, which is why I don't mind the fallout a little bit. So that's kind of what I'm coming to. In case of the Verified blush, I just want to mention, since I'm talking about it a little bit, what we did do to compensate for that was it would have originally been a 6 gram product. I think now we've kept that to a 9 gram product. Whereas, I mean, just putting, I don't mean to plug Verified, but because we're talking about it, I'm like, let me tell you what we did to combat that there was going to be some fallout. That's what we did. We increased the weight overall. And I think Huda's 18 pan palettes are iconic. I think that they always do something different. I love the whole empowered concept that they have going on. If you are a new content creator, so you should know that this is basically a QR code and you can enter and participate in their contest, which is a really cool concept as well. I love that it comes with a nice big mirror. I have, you know, kind of, you can use this on the go, you can use this while traveling, and that's a really fantastic thing. FYI, they don't have just powder products in here. They also have 2 cream products in here. And this one over here, Manifested, am I holding it up enough? Yeah. Manifested is also a mix of powder and cream, and I'll be very honest, I've heard great things about it, but that's the only one in this entire palette I haven't dived into yet, because I'm like, I'm gonna try that on a day when I am just gonna be at home, because if I get it wrong, I will have to literally wipe the whole thing out. And November, December have been such months where I haven't done makeup just to sit at home. I never do that except for when I'm really truly trying a new product out or formulation and in Verified test phase. So I've pretty much tried everything except for that one shade. I've tried 17 out of the 18 pigments here. And no, I'm not going to try it today. Today, I want to do something that I know I will like. I do have an event to go to after, like I mentioned. I have used the burgundy and black, which are cream tones, for nice socket, smoky eye kind of looks. Purpose, which is their black, has gone on to become one of my favorites, even the worthy one, which is that burgundy brown tone that they have over here. Today, I have a jewelry event to go to later, so I don't want to do anything that's gonna make me like make my makeup the center of things, because I'm going for a jewelry event. It is a brand event. I'm gonna be shooting a reel over there, so I want to do something that's neutral and simple and easy to do. And I also feel like that will give you an idea of how versatile this palette is, because it does have a lot of glitter, it does have a lot of shades and a lot of things going on. So I always start off with saying, I'm going to do something simple and da da da, and then I eventually land up doing something so much more. Let's just go with the flow. And I'm going to start off with Keep Going. I'm taking my Verified brush number 8. You have an eyeshadow brush set as well as a complete brush set for eyes, which also includes liner and brows. So in case you're looking out for new brushes, that's for you. I'm just going to give my lid a nice wash with this so that it also sets the foundation concealer we used earlier in place, because I did not apply any loose powder there. I don't apply any loose powder in general on my lids because I know that the eyeshadow is going to come there. So I don't want to layer on layer on layer on layer. This is just easier. Next up, I'm switching to brush number 09. This is a patting and buffing kind of a brush. I am going to go ahead and take a slightly darker tone. So I'm going into Legacy. It's a nice brick brown terracotta-ish shade. And I'm just going to apply this on my outer corner. Pull it inwards to blend it in. I do have deep set eyes, so I go between my brushes quite a bit. If you don't have deep set eyes, you won't have to do that. The simple tip I am going to give you with eyeshadows, and this is something I've learned, again, I've been reminded of rather, because I do one-on-one makeup workshops with you guys. You can book them in if you'd like. I'll leave a link to the form down below in the description section. I do virtual makeup workshops with you guys. One of the things I have come to realize over a period of time is that a lot of people use the exact same brush for all the 3-4 pigments you're working with. And that's not going to give you the kind of finish you're looking for, simply because you're mixing them up. So it's going to look like a little bit of a khichdi on your eyes. So if you really want a different, you know, two-tone gradient, you actually want the finish to look different, I feel like it's important to switch up your brushes. So you can see how easy this was to blend. I just feel like these products are so easy to blend. These are some of the easy, I mean, I've used so many eyeshadow palettes in general in life. And I would hands down say Huda as a brand would be in my top 3. Maybe number 1 even, to be honest. Because the other brands I'm thinking of are also really, really nice. But I think Huda palettes would probably be number 1 on my list. Huda as a brand does so many things right. I'm feeling a little bit less brown here and a little bit more brown here, so I'm just gonna build it up and match it. This is totally fine and normal. Okay, I've matched the brown on both sides. There was a little bit less and a little bit more somewhere in the middle. My battery died, but I've matched the terracotta shade on the outer corner on both sides. What I'm gonna do really quickly is take another fresh brush. This once again is brush number 08. I'm gonna go into the shade Power. This is a really nude light shade that you can use for a matte highlight on your brow bone. I feel like this makes a huge difference because everything is going to have a matte or a nice makeup effect, and then you're going to leave one stretch of skin which is just going to look like skin, and it's going to look like sweat, or it's going to look like just, it's going to have a break in the middle of that perfect look. So I'm going to take the matte highlight. Just FYI, I'm guilty of forgetting this sometimes, and I'm guilty of just being lazy about it, to be honest. I'm just going to go ahead and right below my brows. There you go. It just kind of pulls the whole look in together really nicely. And then for it to truly be my signature style, I'm gonna take very little of this foil. Okay, very, very little. And I'm just gonna drop it towards the inner side. This probably is the only pearly or close to pearly finish, you know, like not really foil, not really glitter, and something that's a nice natural tone, because I don't want it to take all the focus from the eyes. I like how natural and like it just looks well blended and all of that, so I don't want to take that away from the look. What I will do is something again that I sometimes get lazy to do. I'm taking brush number 11. Now, if you remember from my brushes launch video, I mentioned that sometimes I just, like, as not sometimes, but just in general, while doing makeup, those brushes that are meant to go in your lower lash line would be so kadak and so stiff that I would just regret going into that area and just not feel like doing it. In any case, I'm using Best Self with brush number 11. I'm mixing it with Keep Going. So it'll be a nice nude wash on my lower lash line. This will again just kind of pull the look together. You know, it feels good sitting down and doing like a good old beauty video. Like when I started YouTube, which is sit down videos. Vlogs happened after and later. Now, and it's time for a giveaway, and I'm giving away a couple of Huda Beauty lipsticks today. Go on and leave a comment and tell me what was your favorite step in today's routine and why. Huda Beauty as a brand started with lashes, and I would love to do lashes, but where did it go? For my liner, I have a brown liner. So as much as I am, sorry, I'm holding that upside down. There you go. This is what it looks like. So as much as I am a lash person in general, today we're not going to do the lashes because I find brown lashes with brown liner with black lashes a little bit too much of a contrast because the band won't match. And Huda bands typically are a little bit thick. I do have Huda Beauty lashes. I've received those in PR. Ouch. Did I just scratch myself with my own nail? Huda Beauty does have lashes and I have bought them and received them in PR and I have them since a period of time. But today we're not going to use them also because the mascara I have from this brand is mind freaking blowing. I'm getting ahead of myself and talking about the next couple of steps while I haven't even done the liner. So we're really quickly going to do the liner, but just to sum up the eyeshadow, really love Huda shadow palettes, and this one in particular is something I've been reaching for quite a bit. Doing the liner really quickly, not going to talk, always need to concentrate while doing my brows and liner, like I said. Ooh, it's a feather tip, it's not a felt tip. Okay, that was really easy to work with. I've made the outline, just going to fill it in. Okay, this was amazingly easy to work with. It is a felt tip, but it almost feels like a brush tip and not a felt tip. But if it's a brush tip, I should have seen it split somewhere during application, but I didn't. And that's amazing. Really, really, really easy to work with. Very pigmented. I particularly like the shade of brown because I feel like when you're doing non-black shades, like for example, a blue or a green liner even, the shade of what blue it is or what green it is so important. So I really do like that shade. We're going to go into the one step I think I have been most looking forward to do in this video, and that is using legit lashes. I literally put up a shorts about this the other day. I'm so impressed with this product. I really truly am. FYI, I may have the gold limited edition one in my hand over here that I received in PR at the event, but the black one does the same job. It is only a packaging difference. I double checked that with the team at the event itself. I'm not even going to curl my lashes. And you know I'm a little bit of a lazy girly in that zone because I usually just slap on false lashes. I am absolutely smitten with this mascara. It comes with one side for volume, which is what we're going to use now. And then the other side has curl and length. I've used these individually, like on separate days, both sides, and I've used them mixed together, and I think it is so freaking cool. Do you see what I mean? Like, is it picking up on camera? When I'm looking down, I can't see it because then this is the angle and I can't see the lashes at all, but can you see it? A nice thick coat on the upper lashes, and I love what this does. It almost makes it look like I have like really natural falsies on, which is really amazing. I'm not going to use actually this end on the lower lashes. Let's do this. Let's take the curl and length side, I'm sorry. And let's go ahead and add that on the upper lashes as well. So what really changes the game with what the effect of the mascara is also the bristle tip. Oh God, I got some mascara on my lid. I'm going to let it dry. So if you ever get any mascara on your lid, don't go wiping it immediately. I'm going to wait for this dot over here to dry and then wipe it off. And then because this baby over here has a really nice thin brush, thin bristles, I'm going to use this on my lower lash line. And I don't go too ham on my lower lashes because I do again have deep set eyes. And my lashes do sometimes, especially if I lengthen them a lot using the curl and length side. They will end up becoming a mess with my lower lash line and under eye lines. I apply, but I don't go ham like I can on the upper lashes. I don't know why we make all these weird faces in application, to be honest. But we do. I do. And I know a bunch of my friends do. So I'm just assuming we do. What's left? Highlighter. Although this blush radiance is still there, but I am curious to try out the face gloss. This one is also from the Empowered collection. I haven't tried this as yet because the idea of a face gloss has been making me feel a little bit worried, if I'm being perfectly honest. I'm like, it's called Glow Energy, by the way. I'm like a little bit worried about this because what if it looks like my face is sweating. Okay, so this is what the packaging looks like. Looks really interesting. Again, that QR code is all over. And this is what it looks like from the inside. Now, once again, I'm going to address and mention very transparently that I have not used this and I'm a little bit nervous about it because I don't want it to look like my face is sweating. So I'm only getting transparent bits here. Isn't that weird? Should I be digging my nail into it to take some of the highlighter specs as well, or am I just supposed to wait and be patient till those? How is this gonna do anything? Oh, this is literally a face gloss. Like, I don't know what I was expecting, clearly. Okay, so what we have here is a literal face gloss. It doesn't have any color, it doesn't have any reflect, and even on camera, I think it's showing up the same way. I think till I get into the highlighter layer, which is clearly not at surface level, it's much deeper because I'm like really pressing this in to see if I get any of it, and I'm clearly not getting it. So you have to hit pan and then you'll get it, is my guess. It is literally meant to look like the most natural highlighter because it will just be the color of whatever is underneath. I'm actually very curious to try this on no makeup. How awesome would that be? Or like no foundation. What's really amazing is that it's not shifting anything from underneath, because that to me is a wonder. Like that was one of the things I was worried about. I'm like, it's a gloss. What if it moves whatever is underneath? But it's not moving whatever was underneath. Impressed. Was not expecting that. In a way, it kind of worked out that the blush barely had any tint but had some dewiness, because that way with the gloss, it just loaded up on the radiance and the glossy finish. So I'm not mad at it at all. I definitely feel like you can see the gloss. Am I worried that this may look like sweat when I'm really up about on a crazy day? Yes, but that's what powder products are for. This is a little bit more editorial, a little bit more glam, a little bit more meant for evening looks than meant for regular day wear. I like the way it sits on the skin, and I'm going to repeat and say particularly that I like the way it doesn't move the other products, which is something I was clearly worried about. Again, I'm curious to see how it's on no makeup and curious to see how it performs on top of a powder blush. Yeah, I might be repeating some of the points here, but that's because I'm thinking so many things about the products at the same time. Last but not the least, it is time for me to wipe off my lip oil and go in and work on the lip. What do we do for the lips today? I feel like since we're going really nice, neutral, simplish, but still glam, I want to keep it still very nude-like on the lips. I do have a couple of lip liners from Huda Beauty. I have Bombshell and Trophy Wife. I'm leaning towards Bombshell because I also have Bombshell liquid lipstick over here. So it'll be a perfect, perfect match. Really quickly going to go ahead and line my lips. I know that some people like to go all over their lip with a lip liner as well, but I don't like to overlayer, if that makes any sense, using Bombshell and filling out my lips. Okay, first thing I want to address towards the end of this video pretty much is that the foundation has settled in beautifully. So definitely leave some room for the oxidizing factor. I was so worried about it at the time of application, as you saw, but you can see that it has oxidized and come together really, really beautifully. Now I'm gonna dive into my real, like, what was a hit and what was a miss and what I would recommend you to invest in. Let's go from the start. Foundation. I, in all honesty, would give this foundation a miss only because I feel like it's giving my face a very matte finish, but it's not settling in very well into the crevices or my laugh lines. So for me, if I have to apply powder all over my face to set a liquid foundation in as a dry skin girl, that's a little bit of a red flag for me. So while I do like that it's settled in, just in general, it's making my skin look good. The fact that I can see some amount of just, just not fully settled in near my lines is a little bit of a bothering point. The flat surfaces like the forehead or the cheek, absolutely zero problems with, but this is what's kind of the deal breaker for me. The concealer, I absolutely love. I think that they have knocked it out of the park with the concealer. I am not seeing much creasing. In fact, it's very, very negligible. With so many other concealers, I see more creasing. I'm really, really happy with the coverage. I love that it didn't go full coverage in one go, so I could possibly wear this every day as well. Let me know if you want me to do a natural wear kind of makeup with the concealer, like no foundation routine with that concealer, and I can do it probably in a shorts format for you. Let me know what you think of that down below in the comments. Always listening and, you know, to what you want. Tantour is an absolute hit for me. Tantour for me is a product that I have again reached out for over and over again. Very easy to work with. I love it. The cheek tint for me is gonna have to be a miss, unfortunately, just because it doesn't seem like the kind of product I see myself reaching for very often. I want to be honest and say I am not a stick blush person. If you are, this could work for you. After this, we went into the eyes, and I think it's a little bit of a no-brainer that this eyeshadow palette gets a hit from me. It's a super hit for me, if you ask me. So just gonna put that out there. And then the mascara and liner both are absolute hits for me. I feel like they both worked really, really, really well together as well. When it comes to the gloss, I'm a little bit confused because I do really love it. So off the bat, formulation, hit. I just don't know how much of it normal people who don't work in beauty, like for example, if you're going to go to office every day, are you going to use that? No, you're going to land up buying that product and use it maybe once a week if you're a Saturday night editorial glam kind of girl. Even then, I would personally land up reaching for a powder highlighter, so it stays on longer. It doesn't accidentally look like sweat, although I love the way it is gleaming. But just in case you're someone who's experimental with makeup, from a formula standpoint, hit. And then I think we're down to the last products, which are the lip liner and lipstick, and they both get hits from me because I've been using them and repurchasing them. And like, if I show you my Huda Beauty lipstick collection over the years, you'll just be like, what the hell, that's crazy. Have I covered everything? Yeah, I think I covered everything. I hope you're going to participate in the giveaway in this video. I am, as you may have seen through the course of this video, I am giving away 2 Huda Beauty lipsticks, Icon and Bombshell. I hope you'll participate. All the details for this will have been in the part of the giveaway, as well as down below in the description section. Tell me what you think of this look, please. I'm dying to hear your thoughts. And I will see you in the next one. I really hope you've enjoyed the Vlogmas series. And I hope you subscribe to my channel. I'll see you in the next one. Thanks for watching. Bye.